Hello, my dear programmers. Today we are going to learn about Java programming. So we are going to solve hackathon problems by using Java language. So let's get started. Rank. Okay, hackathon first step. Please come. Okay. For developers, we are the developers, so we are learning in the developer sections. So if you are companies, then logging into company, that means recruiters, yeah, just you. So logging, I'm logging into my account. So let's rock it up. So today I have solved two problem solving programs. So I will discuss you how to solve that problems in a better and efficient manner. So let's get into one. Continue operation. So we have first of all we are solving some first two problems, then tomorrow we are solving another two problems in a better and understanding way. So the problem is will come. I'm sorry, no need. So solve me faster. So the first problem is solving first. As you see the code, I will move my screen. Okay, so basically complete the function solving first to compute the sum of two integers. So basically we have to get the sum of two numbers, that means a equal to 7, b equal to 3. So 7 plus 3 10, we have to return the 10 in functional programming manner. So let's read the function description. Complete the solve me first function in the editor below. So here solve me function is already present. So I have morning, I have changed it. I'm now going into Java again. Java 7, okay. And there is a solve me first. So solve me first function is in the editor below. So solve me has the following parameters. Int a, it has the parameter int a and int b, okay. Return the sum of a and b. So actually 7 plus 3 sum is 10, we have to return that 10. So constraints are numbers less than one, less than 1000 and greater than 1. So sample output will be 5. So sample input a equal to 2, b equal to 3. So sample output will be 5. So expression 2 plus 3 equal to 5. So the manner is we have to solve in functional ways, functional programming approach. So let's see how I solve my program. Then after you have to also solve in your system. So let's get into the problem. So these are the header files. Basically in this program we will require util package and that only one is required. So these are given, okay, leave it. So public class name is solution, class name whatever it may be. So our program will be, our class name will be solving for addition. Okay, our class name will be addition. Okay, then this is the function, as you know, static int. Static is the constant specifier. Static is the function. Our function name is solving first. Parameters are int a comma int b. Okay, int type here int also given. Yeah, type return a plus b. So we have to return a plus b. Actually I will explain you how to solve the program in a logical way. So public static void main string, or it is a main function. The program will always start in the main function. So let's scanner, it is for input, taking for input. We have used scanner class. It is in is an object. Okay, new scanner, new is a keyword which you have to initialize the objects. So ignore it, just know scanner is a class and in is an object of scanner class. So int a we have declared, a we have taken, int a is a variable. In variable we are putting the values in it. So int b also given, int b is a variable is declared. So b equal to int in dot next int. So next int is a, we given the b value as 3, so a value as 2. By in the HackerRank platform, the already input is given automatic manner. So int sum, we have to do sum operation. So sum equal to, we calling the function. Basically functions are executed whenever we call it. So solve main function, we have calling the function a comma b, system dot out print sum, we are printing the sum. So just a small logic is, wait for another moment. I will also explain another, apart from functional programming, I am going to explain about in very simple manner how to calculate two numbers in better and efficient manner. So first of all, we have to solve this program, and then after I will show you my approach or simple way. Basically, you have to follow functional approach. This is, my approach will also be helpful you. So first of all, we do this. This is simple. We have to return a plus b. So our job is done. A plus b. So return a plus b. So I have to compile it. Run code. The code is running. Now what will happen? Yahoo! Test case are passing. Test case 0 is 2 plus 3. Actually, 2 input 2 a equal to and b as 3. So a equal to b as 3, 5. Our output is 5 and expected output is also 5. So congratulations, we have passed the first program. So I have, as you know, I have promised that I show another process, and that is easy calculation. So first of all, I remove it. I'm going to Java it is cam. So I'm erasing this one because I don't need this. First, you have to declare util package. So you have to import util package. Importing util package. Import java dot util dot util package. No need to all import all the libraries in it. We just need scanner. So I'm writing scanner. If you don't know the what you want, then enter the star for it. That this enough. If you don't know what class you have to import, then util dot star all the libraries what you have needed and load in it. So next we have to declare a class. So class name is public. Class name will be sum. Okay, sum. We are going to perform sum operations. Okay, and we have to next up main method. We have to declare the main method. Public. Static means constant. Static void main return type. Void is return type. Main is a main method. String or string in string box. I remember it. S is a capital. String box. Okay. We have to open it. Then the coding will start from now onwards. The execution will begin from now onwards. Let's watch it carefully. We have to declare the scanner class, as you know, for taking input. Scanner for SE, we have to declare small as of SE equal to new is a keyword. Scanner system.in. Okay, system.in. Okay, we have imported scanner class. I have written scanner class. And object is also created, so we need to declare two variables, int a comma int b for addition operation. So int a comma int b, I have declared that we have to take input. So to take input, so a equal to sc dot next in for taking input from the user. Next in function. Okay, so as well as for b, taking for b value, we are also taking sc dot next int method. Okay, we have taken two variables, we have initialized two variables, and the input function we have also given. So next we have to do arithmetic calculation. That means we have to join a plus b. What's the sum? A plus b. So okay, sum equal to int sum equal to a plus b. Okay, we have sum up a plus b values. We have to show the sum. How? By using system dot out dot println. So here sum will be printed out. Okay, we will going to run this code. What happened? We will see. Running this code. Okay, yeah, our approach is also successful. So hit like button if you like this, share and subscribe our channel for more interesting programming like these videos. So not this, I have also showing you another program. So let's watch till the end. I will give you one bonus program also in homework. So congratulations, you have passed the sample test cases. Yahoo! In your interviews, we have the coding questions also given. We have to pass the as well as some test cases. So in that test case are also present. You have to pass that in a better and efficient manner like this. The first one is a functional programming and the second one is my approach, that simple approach. You can follow both approaches, but most of all you have to follow functional programming because in companies, in exams, companies are asking functional approach. So remember it. So we are going into next one, next problem actually. Okay, I'm going to submit it. Yahoo, my all test cases are also success. Compilation is success. So I'm going to next challenge right now. Okay, the next challenge is climb up algorithms. Sorry. Simple array sum. We are going to solve simple array sum. Given an array, basically as you know, an array is a finite ordered collection of homogeneous data. It stores similar kind of data in a sequential order. Our array is given in this program, array is given. We have to calculate the elements of the array in a sequential order. So array is equal to 1, 2, 3. We have to calculate elements in it. 1 plus 2 plus 3 equal to 6. We have to write 6. So in also we are doing, in this I have doing in a procedural manner. We can also do a functional manner. Simple array, okay. So first line is n. We have taken, so I will explain you. So 6, input is 6. That means 6 elements we are going to declare. So 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 4, 13. 13 plus 10, 23. 23 plus 11, 31. So that's the answer will be 31. First of all, we have to import util package for taking input from the user. The class name will be ArraySum. We have declared main method, then scanner input. For input, we have declared scanner class int n, j. For n, we have taken a number of array elements, what you want to have, what you want to. So n, we have declared n. For j, for temporary variable, next, the main keyword j is working in here. So how it works, let's see. N, we have declared n for taking input. We have declared array, basically array declared as data type array name, square brackets equal to new is a keyword, int, yeah, size will be n. Because whatever the user has entered in n, our n will be come here. So next, for loop, int I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. For loop, we are running for loop. This is for taking input. Basically, this is used for loading, sorry, or representing loading array. So you can consider loading items or elements. Okay, loading items or elements. Area of I, we are reading c dot next enter. So next, for int I equal to 0, this is the formula to sum up the array elements. How was it? We have declared temporary variable j here, then j plus equal to area of I. Initially j equal to 0. Okay, area of I will be first of all 1. 1 plus 0, what happened? 1 plus 0, 1. So 1 will be going into j variable. So next time 0 less 0 will be 1, I will be incremented 1. 1 less than here 6. Yes, condition is true. Then J will be J actually initially 1 plus the value 1 will be 2. So the index value 1 will be here 2. So 1 plus 2, 3. The sum will be 3. And next time, J value increases as 3. 3 less than 6. Condition is true. So 3. So area of I is 3. So previous is 3, 9. Next after 4. The array value will be 4. And 1, 2, 3. Sorry, it's 3. The I value will be 3. 3 less than 6. Condition is true. True. So what are the in third place? 4. 4 plus 6. 10. So 10. Okay. Then now then I will be included as a 4. 10 plus 10. 20. Then next after iteration. 10 plus 11. 23 plus 11. 31. I think wrong. Four, three plus 6, 7, 10, 20. 20 plus 10, 11. 11 will be come up here. Now order print 11. We print the J value. So J value will be 31. So we have running this code. Running code. What will be running? Oh, this is also true. Congratulations. The code test case is passed. Okay, we are going to now submit. Okay, our hidden test case are also passed. So tomorrow we will discuss some other problems in HackerRank. If you like this video, hit a like and subscribe and share to your friends and whoever learn programming.